and honor our veterans. At this time, we will have the presentation of colors.
Color guard, attention. Color guard, advance.
Thank you.
Red Skeleton, one of America's best-loved comedians and star of motion pictures, radio, and television, was also a true patriot, a man who loved his country, its flag, and the freedom America stood for. On January 14, 1969, Red touched the hearts of millions of Americans with his Pledge of Allegiance, in which he explained the meaning of each and every word. At this time, we will watch the video of Red Skeleton, What the Pledge Means to Me.
I remember a teacher that I had. Now, I went through the seventh grade. I went to the seventh grade. I left home when I was 10 years old because I was hungry. I work in the summer, I go to school in the winter. But I had this one teacher who was the principal of the Harrison School in Vincennes, Indiana. To me, this was the greatest teacher, a real sage of my time, anyhow. He had such wisdom. And we were all reciting the Pledge of Allegiance one day. And he walked over, this little teacher, Mr. Laswell was his name. Mr. Laswell. He says, I have been listening to you boys and girls recite the Pledge of Allegiance all semester, and it seems as though it's becoming monotonous to you. If I may I recite it and try to explain to you the meaning of each word.
I.
Me, an individual, a committee of one.
Pledge.
To call myself worthy, good, to give without self-pity.
Allegiance.
My love and my devotion.
To the flag.
Our standard, old glory, a symbol of courage, and wherever she waves, there is respect, because your loyalty is given her a dignity that shouts freedom is everybody's job.
Of the United.
That means we have all come together.
States.
Individual communities that have united into 48 great states, 48 individual communities with pride and dignity and purpose, all divided by imaginary boundaries, yet united to a common cause, and that's love of country.
Of America and to the Republic.
Thank you. Dog as their mascot. The Marines' nickname is Leatherneck. The Marines train in either Paris Island, South Carolina, or San Diego, California.
There has been 123 people in the Marines that were active but got killed during war. The Marines use the oldest weapon in active service.
Marines' birthday is November 10th. The Marines were born at the Revolutionary War. Marines have their own band.
Hoorah is a chant or saying. It means a Marine is greeting another or is an expression of enthusiasm.
Hoorah! Thank you for your service, Marines. This is my rifle. There's many like it, but this one is mine. My rifle is my best friend. It is my life. I must master it as I must master my life. My rifle without me is useless. Without my rifle, I am useless. I must fire my rifle true.
Navy fights under the sea.
Thank you.
You protect us.
Thank you.
You make peace, Navy.
Thank you.
You fight even when you hurt.
Thank you.
Even though you lose friends, you fight.
Thank you.
You use your skills to help us.
Thank you.
You fight even when you are sad.
Thank you.
You're the best.
We know that they weren't asked to come because they wanted to work for our freedom. We know they care because they work for land, sea, and air. 8, 6, 4, 2. We just wanted to thank you!
Today we learned about the Air Force.
The Air Force launches bombs from the sky.
They fix the broken planes. The Air Force shares the birthday with the CIA.
Their chant is aim high, fly, fight, win.
There are 631,144 people in the Air Force.
The Air Force fights in global relief. The Air Force used to be in the Army 67 years ago.
Thank you. You're the best.
Supposed to have had it.
gravy on the pie, canned fruit, and potatoes, and corn, and that dark night when we started for Southern France, most of the boys got seasick and passed the luck and back. Everyone was tense and quiet, and then we got Puerto Rico. No figures in the dark, that early morning hour, straining our eyes to see more. Some of us lucky to have a great view, and some who have ended up hanging in their shoe, five just out there, and then a German soldier put a bayonet through them. Two or three landed in the water and drowned, as we had too much ammunition on us to stay afloat long enough to get through the parachute. There was a lot of confusion and a lot of scared boys to get organized. Veterans gave their lives to go into the war, suffered through hardships, and may have given the ultimate sacrifice of their own life to protect their freedom. Each veteran deserves to have his story told, just like my dear friend. Please open your hearts and listen to all those who have sacrificed, and thank them for being courageous, selfless, and amazing people. We all owe them. So on this Veterans Day, when the entire country rises to give salute and to honor the service of all military men and women, a feeling of deep respect and thankfulness flows my mind. I know that all men and women, a feeling. I know that gratitude, respect, and love can in no way match these veteran sacrifices, but we can, this important day, recognize those who have given their lives to work, but also for those who have formed the human forces. This is a great opportunity to celebrate one choice, one base to serve the country, whether in the past or present. I'd like to close with a short poem to say thank you. We owe them a lot. On Veterans Day, we remember again our men and women who have served. We honor them now for what they did then, the liberties they deserve. Let's not forget their sacrifice, the hard, heavy work they have done. They did, and what they had proposed act. Crucial needs they fulfill with a telephone, pencil, or a gun. We are happy and proud to honor them. They gave so much more than they got us. Our heroes, our veterans, have created today. All of us will honor them. Thank you.
Thank you. I would like to tell a short story about that I heard a little while ago. There is this man, he had a son that was in the military. He had passed away, and son's wishes were to have his ashes put in the sand in Italy. There's this young man on the beach when he was spreading the ashes. He said, "Thank you. My great grandmother is alive today because your son thought, paid forward for the men and women that served. We owe them the world for them giving their life for us. Thank you."
this time, please welcome our Badger Girl representative, McKenna Delaney.
Many of you may know the name Ernie Pyle. The award-winning American journalist and war correspondent who had interviewed many soldiers during World War II, including my great uncle, Dick Kelso. Now, one of Ernie Pyle's more famous quotes is that last we are up to it in our necks and everything has changed, even our outlook on life. And that last part strikes me every time I read it. Even your outlook on life has changed. What he leaves out is what that outlook has changed to. Being in the military drastically transforms a person, no matter what position they hold. All of these people living here who served were extremely changed. They became a part of something bigger than themselves and gave up their lives to be a part. I asked all of my active military friends why they chose the military, and their answers inspired me, and I realized that even though that outlook on life changes, there are still some of the same fundamental principles that they begin with veterans today. When a soldier leaves, they are a part of something bigger and better than their individual self. That never changes. When they come home, they are still a part of that, even those who have passed. They are the embodiment of dignity, honor, integrity, selflessness, and courage. They show us what it means to be American, why that flag means so much. They show us through their everyday lives that we are here because of them. They show us that sacrifice they made when they chose to be that something bigger. So today we need to thank them. Let them know that that sacrifice was well worth it. Our freedom that they gave us is being used to its utmost fullest. In all honesty, I originally did not know what to begin with. How was I supposed to use my words in a way that held to the standards of these incredible people? And so they say that poetry is the art of making the ineffable effable. To be able to put into words what normally cannot be. So this poem conveys the emotions that I had trouble putting into words. Today is the day we honor the noble and the brave, the men and women who dedicated their lives and the sacrifices they made. When America had an urgent need, they were the first to raise their hand. Without thinking twice about it, they were proud to take a stand. So, some came back from war with battle scars, others in flag-draped coffins. And even though that their flesh may have left, their spirits are never forgotten. They unselfishly and knowingly put their lives on the line. So, when you see a veteran, thank them, because without them, freedom would have died. Thank you.
Veterans, please stand to be recognized when you hear your song.
Return to your ranks. now the seniors line up over here. In the back. Of the veterans exit first.
Thank you guys. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.